Now that you've added your first app to Bitrise, let's take a look at what steps and workflows are. First, click the name of your app, then click on Workflow. This will open the Workflow Editor, where you'll be able to set up a workflow for your app for any scenario or development stage you're in. On the left, you can find your steps. Steps represent blocks of script execution with predefined input and output variables. Put a sequence of steps together and you get a workflow. There are two default workflows, one for testing and another one for deployment. These workflows are different for each type of app, depending on the platform. Most of the time, a build is made up of a single workflow, but you can change this. Our scanner recognizes Jasmine and Karma Jasmine testing solutions. If your project uses another test framework or runner, our scanner will not be able to generate a test workflow, but it will generate a build workflow instead called primary workflow. We are testing our app, so we have both workflows. This one here is the primary workflow for an Ionic app. It includes a run npm command step that will add JavaScript dependencies to your project. As our app has Karma Jasmine dependency in its package.json file, our scanner has detected it and automatically inserted the respective testing step into our workflow. In the deploy workflow, you'll also find both the run npm command and the Karma Jasmine test runner steps, along with the certificate and profile installer step. That one is needed for the iOS code signing. You can find two Ionic-specific steps in the deploy workflow. Generate Cordova build configuration, that works for Ionic apps too, and Ionic archive. The generate Cordova build configuration step contains all the configuration required for the Ionic archive step. As such, both steps are essential for deploying your app. Steps represent a block of script execution with predefined input and output variables. Steps are basically the building blocks of your configuration. Workflows are made up of steps executed one after the other. You can already find some app-specific ones in the default workflows, but whenever you need to, you can delete them, rearrange them, or simply add new ones. If you click on the plus sign, you can see the step library, all filtered according to the platform you're working with. You can also switch to a non-platform specific view by clicking All. Here, you can browse between all the different types of steps: test, deploy, notification, utility, or you can search for a specific one, for example, Slack. Once you've found it, you just click it and it will pop up in your workflow. If you can't find the step you're looking for, you can always create your own. They're all open source, so knock yourself out. Let's try configuring some steps. How about we take a look at the run npm command step. If you click on it, all of its input variables will appear to the right. Steps have two kinds of inputs, required and optional. If any of the required inputs do not have valid values, the step will fail. You can also get more information about an input by clicking on it. Environment variables or envars can be used as step inputs as well. You can modify a step input by either clicking into the input field and typing it in manually, or by clicking the change option next to the input field and then the purple insert variable button. Through here, you can find a list of all available environment variables. Take a look at them, and when you find the one you're looking for, just click it and it will be inserted into the input field for you. If you can't find what you're looking for, no worries, you can set up envars, environmental variables, through the app's dedicated tab, located up here. There's a special type of envar called secret envar. Sensitive information, such as those needed in the certificate and profile installer step, should always be stored as secrets, as they will be redacted and not shown in build logs. You can create a secret envar by clicking on a step's input field marked sensitive. This one will be called job secret. I'll add a random set of numbers as a value and then add it to the step. Later on, you'll be able to find these under the secrets tab. You can make secret envars even safer by marking them protected, after which neither you nor anybody with the access to the app can unlock or check their values again. Your secrets will be safe with us. Now you know how to configure and customize steps and their inputs, and the sort of workflows they're in. You can create new ones, then chain them together, rearrange them, and just customize them any way you want to. When you're done configuring everything, try running a new build. Click on the name of the app, then schedule the build. If you already feel comfortable enough with the workflow editor, you can also start thinking about further ways to build, test, and deploy your app. Feel free to leave a comment below. You want to be an expert? Check out the whole playlist for the topic, link in the description below.